Hello everyone, bonjour à toutes et à tous. I'm Benoît, I come from France. Je m'appelle Benoît, je viens de France et je vais vous présenter quelques petites choses à propos de l'équipe Growth. I'm going to show you some nice features coming from the Growth team. So I hope you will find all the information you need in this presentation that you're enjoying. This event. So first of all, I'm Benoît. I've been a long time volunteer since 2008. I'm helping newcomers to make their first steps at French Wikipedia. That's my main, area of interest. I'm also one of the staff members of the Wikimedia Foundation. I joined in 2015, and I've been involved in multiple projects. And nowadays, I'm working on welcoming newcomers, which is completely compatible with what I do as a volunteer. So being part of the growth team is a nice thing. But before I will, before my presentation of the growth features, I will show you some background in order to understand what we are discussing about. So I'm going to explain to you what's the growth team and what the growth team currently does, and also a quick presentation of the future. So why the growth team? Well, growing the wiki is something very important, but it's also very difficult. Having newcomers joining the wikis and participating has always been a challenge for any wiki of any size. So it could be about, you know, main languages spoken worldwide, but it would also be a blocker for some other communities or other languages located at places all over the world, especially, you know, at the far north. As you know, being on Wikipedia, starting on Wikipedia is very difficult. You have to understand some strange points that are not the way you're thinking about a website. When you want to participate in websites, it's super complicated. We have multiple barriers. So the first barrier is, for instance, technical. It's about adding info boxes or creating links. It's not that easy. You need to understand the vocabulary. You need to understand how technically things work. Also, we have some conceptual barriers, which are like, what is a good reference? What is neutral point of view? These are things easy to explain when you are face to face, but when you are just in front of your computer or your mobile phone trying to do something on Wikipedia, it's much more complicated. We also have cultural barriers, like where am I supposed to post a message? How do I reply to someone? And so on. So these main barriers have been highlighted by a research that has been conducted in 2018. And this research project has been conducted in two countries that have specific wikis spoken only, well, where the language is only spoken in these countries. So I invite you to have a look at these new editor experiences, which are located at mediawiki.org. You will certainly find some things you have already observed when you are on your wiki, where newcomers seems to be blocked or not understanding what's going on. As a consequence, after this identification process, the growth team, the idea of the growth team has been well designed. The idea is to grow and diverse our contributors, not only people who know how to use a computer or people who are familiar with academic research could be able to contribute. We need to have more people, and they shouldn't be blocked because of technical, cultural, or conceptual reasons. As a consequence, it's been decided to create a team that will try to increase the number of contributors and also increase the diversity of these contributors. The growth team has been funded at the Wikimedia Foundation in July 2018, And we started with 8 teammates, and now we are 12 people full-time and 4 ambassadors. Why the ambassadors? Well, we try to develop features that are really useful for every wiki in the world, every Wikipedia in particular. And as a consequence, we need to try the tools in order to, well, check if it's working properly in every possible situation. So we are working closely with 4 wikis, Arabic, Bengali, Czech, and Vietnamese. And this way, we have a large diversity of communities and languages. In these wikis, we have part-time ambassadors. They are community members. They know the community, they know the tools, they know how Wikipedia works, and they can help us in order to define the tools and then try the tools, make some community engagement so that these communities try the tools first, and then we can release the tools to more people. We also have a close monitoring in these wikis. We measure the audience. We try to check to get some data, and we check if the tools are efficient by comparing what's going on the wiki with a control group, which is a set of users who have the default experience. So I'm going to show you the growth features. These features are available right now. You can ask to have them, and well, actually, if you just want to wait until they arrive on your wiki, they will arrive very soon. So wait for it. I'm going to say more about it later. First, a small reminder about the objective of the growth features. So we try to build a set of tools that help newcomers to make their first steps on the wikis. And most important thing, these tools are both working on mobile and desktop. They have been designed in parallel in order to work on any kind of support. The first tool, so to speak, newcomers will get when they arrive on the wiki is a form. We want to understand why people create an account on Wikipedia. This is the kind of data also we can share with communities so that communities can improve their workflows. They can also improve their web pages and all the processes around being part of the wiki. So people are welcome to fill this welcome survey, and then immediately after signing up, they are redirected to a new special page we've built just for them. So the page is the home page. We call it the home page. It's a centralized place where newcomers can find any kind of resources they need when they start editing the wiki. I'm showing you the interface in Arabic with English language. I know it can be a bit confusing, but well, it was a bit complicated to find a more internationalized display. The first item you see on the homepage is the impact module. So here my impact module is blank because I haven't made any edits yet. But when I will have, you know, done some edits, then I will see how many people have seen the page I edited. It's really encouraging people. We have some feedback from both newcomers and experienced users who were like, wow, I had no idea how many people were reading the articles I edited. The second module is a very important one. It's a direct access to a mentor, a welcomer. So the goal there is to reach at newcomers first before they need help. At the moment, at most wikis, when you want to have to get some help, you need to find someone who will help you, and you need to understand how to contact that person who can potentially help you. And sometimes, well, these people are unfortunately not people who are aiming to help. So we decided to give a try to this feature, which is to just assign an experienced user, a volunteer experienced user, to any newcomer. I'm personally a mentor myself at my home wiki as a volunteer, and it's really a very nice experience. It's a way to get some questions about very interesting things, and getting a mentor is a way to start very interesting conversations about how to edit and how to help. It's a way, you know, to call for a mentor. For a mentor. So we picked that from the New Editor Experiences study I mentioned earlier. We needed to build a way to find intermediaries who can explain and guide people through the wiki, which is what we cover through this this module. On the homepage, you also have access to help links. These links are the top, most important links the community decides to display to newcomers. Usually it's about how to edit a page, how to add an image, how to write a good article. These links are community created and can be changed anytime. We have added a banner at the top of the homepage, so it's not displayed all the time, but it's a way to invite newcomers to campaigns that are designed just for them. So think about it, you know, have a place where newcomers arrive and they can immediately be redirected to a campaign that's open to their contributions. And the big thing, actually, in the middle of the homepage is suggested edits. It's a key feature, and it's where we are focusing most of our development efforts at the moment. So we have discovered that it's complicated for newcomers to know what to do when they arrive on the wiki. At the moment, you create an account and then, well, you're left alone. So we want newcomers to try by editing. We want them to make some real edits, but we don't want these edits to be painful for the community or for the wiki or harmful. So we try to guide people. So when you arrive on the homepage, you are asked to choose some topics of interest. So we have 32 topics, if I remember correctly, and these topics are covering very various fields. When you pick some of the fields you like, here I picked transportation and Africa, why not? Then you move on and you select the kind of edits you want to make. You have the choice between easy edit, medium edits, and hard edits. We try to encourage newcomers to start with easy edits, of course, then to move on to medium and then hard edits. The goal is to find articles newcomers can edit based on what they like and also the kind of skills they want to develop. When a newcomer selects an edit, then they have access to a list of articles. They can choose one of these articles, and when they click on the article, they directly access to the article itself in editing mode. It's working both with the visual editor and Wikitext. We tried privilege with visual editor because, well, learning Wikitext and learning all the rest of the wiki is too complicated. So we try to have an approach of visual editing first. So when the newcomer has selected an article, like this article about a submarine, again on Arabic Wikipedia, they are guided with the help panel. So the help panel is a panel that's a collapsible panel where you have steps that will guide you in order to make the edits you want to make. You have some tips about how, for instance, here, how to expand a short article. Oh, so the big question about all of this is it working? Because it's not only a matter of developing tools, you know, it's perfectly possible to decide about developing a tool and voila. But in the case of the growth team, we try to understand what's working and what is not working. And what we have discovered so far is the fact that, well, it's working. Newcomer task, especially, so when you go through an article that has been suggested and when you are guided in order to make these the changes, it's been proven to increase the probability that newcomers make a first edit on the wiki. We have plus 11% of newcomers who start editing, they are encouraged by this new system. We have discovered also that the probability of this first edit being productive is higher than the control group we have made. On the classical experience, it's more likely that people will do not that good edits. We have an higher probability of people being retained as editors, so it's a way to grow the community. And also, people come back because they are guided. They know where to find ways to edit the wiki. They know what kind of topic they can edit. So we have 22% more people returning to the wiki in order to make some new edits. We also had a look at the revert rate in order to check if edits made by newcomers are the same or if they are different. Well, the rate is about the same. It's not a clear way to check if an edit is successful or not, because as you have probably experienced at NoWiki, some people prefer to revert in order to fix. So, well, the revert rate hasn't been counted as a proper tool to check if the tool is working. But overall, what needs to be taken into account is the fact that these tools have been proven to work. I put the link, the shortcut to the research study we've made about this. And of course, everything is open source. You can have a look at it. So, these tools are working. And as a consequence, the decision has been taken to go to more wikis. So at the moment, we have 40 wikis that use the growth features. And we have an ongoing deployment to all Wikipedias. This will happen in the coming month. So you have two possibilities there. You can contact me in order to get these tools at your wiki, in order to increase your chances to have newcomers being retained. Or you can, if you like, just wait for my message. I will inform your community very, very soon about what are the next steps and how we are going to give you the tools. We also consider the feedback from communities, and at the moment, the most common feedback we got is about, mentors. People who are helping newcomers, they are asking to have some tools to work with newcomers, and it's the next coming feature. So, the next features we also plan to work on, it's a way to help welcomers, like I said. But also we want to offer more tasks to newcomers. We want to offer easier tasks to newcomers because at the moment, even the easiest one may be a bit complicated when you need to understand that you have to create a link at the wiki. It could be considered as complicated. So we want to create some easier tasks. We want to reduce the number of configuration steps required by communities to get the tools. And we want, as I said, deploy to more wikis. So in order to simplify all this, I'm going to give you a quick tour of what's next. We start with OnWiki configuration, so it will come very soon. A special page will be available for communities in order to configure the tools, to configure which help pages are used, which templates are used for suggested edits and so on. The goal is to give some independence to the wikis so that they can decide which links could be used, which templates should be used, and then the tools will grow at the same time as the community work on welcoming newcomers. As I already mentioned, another short-term project will be the mentor dashboard. So it will be a special page where mentors can monitor the activities of their newcomers. It's a way to increase the quality of the relationship between newcomers and their mentors. And if you're curious about it, again, you can have a look at the different pages I linked at the bottom of this slide in order to know more about the this upcoming project. Our next midterm project is to break down the workflow of editing in order to make wiki editing being available for all kinds of people and on more devices. So we are currently working, and actually the pilot wikis are trying a new way to add links. So for instance, you open an article in the add link mode, and some links are suggested inside of the article. Just have to say yes, no, maybe, or yes, no, I don't know. And then you make a real edit this way. So you just have to confirm some suggested edits. It's a way to understand how adding wiki links would work, how the workflow around adding links exists on the wiki, to learn how to do this. And we plan to work on a new way to add images to pages where no images have been added so far. So we have a lot of other potential projects that are about, well, quite anything you can imagine regarding helping newcomers. So if you're curious about all this, I invite you to visit our pages at mediawiki.org. Just type growth in the search bar and you will find our landing page. We also have a talk page, of course, where you can ask any kind of question, place any kind of feedback, make some requests. You can also contact me directly. My email is just right there on the slides. And if you're just curious about what could be the next steps, well, please subscribe to our newsletter. Thank you for having a look at this video. Thank you for staying until the end of the video. It's really it's really nice to you. I wish you a great rest of the Arctic night. Enjoy it, and special thanks to Richard for helping me to record this video. All the best, and like we say in France, au revoir et à très bientôt.